Good morning, everyone. We've recorded 19 cases to 8 p.m. yesterday evening. 17 of those cases are linked, and two remain under investigation. Of the 19 new cases, only six were infectious in the community. Unfortunately, we have a small cluster of cases in our disability community, a little into double digits, around 10 to 12. This includes people living with disability and disability support workers. The government acknowledges the anxiety that this is causing and can advise that we have been actively supporting the affected individuals and the broader community. And Minister Stephen Smith will talk further to this. Yesterday, 3,640 tests were conducted in the ACT. Wait times for testing are shorter than have been experienced earlier in the outbreak and earlier in the week. The weather forecast for Monday and Tuesday, though, is for quite a lot of rain. This will have an impact on our pop-up testing clinics. So our advice today is that if you have been waiting to get a test, wait times are much lower, and today would be a very good day to do so. ACT policing advise that around 450 traffic stops were conducted yesterday, and only two directions were required to leave the ACT. Engagement with businesses remains excellent, and we thank all of those businesses for working so hard to support the community and to operate safely. Overall, the community response remains very, very good. Reports of breaches of public health directions can be made to ACT Police through an online form or on the Access Canberra website or by calling the COVID-19 helpline on 6207 7244. In relation to vaccinations, Canberrans continue to come forward to get vaccinated in great numbers. We've reached around 60% of the population with first doses now administered. The ACT's vaccination rates continue to be well above the national average. Yesterday, 1,408 first doses were administered at ACT government clinics and 1,205 second doses. In total, our government clinics have administered nearly 17,000 first and second doses over the last week. This effort, together with the great work of our GPs and pharmacists, is seeing a very strong vaccination program for the ACT. So we encourage people to have that conversation with their trusted health professional, GP or pharmacist. You can access AstraZeneca vaccines today. And of course, we continue to run our ACT government programs, both Pfizer and AstraZeneca, across our various clinics. It's encouraging to see how many people are coming forward to get vaccinated. So in summary, 19 new cases, 17 linked to known cases and exposure sites, two still under investigation, six of the 19 unknowingly infectious in the community. This number today was, as foreshadowed yesterday by Dr. Coleman, a reflection of the slight change in the reporting cut-off times. It is a larger number than yesterday. It does reflect the situation that we face, that there will still be new cases in the days ahead. And what we're striving for is that all of those new cases are not infectious in the community. I'll now invite Dr. Coleman to provide some further information on the new cases and the epidemiology. Following Dr. Coleman, Health Minister Rachel Stephen-Smith will provide a further update. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Chief. I'm Karen Coleman, the ACT Chief Health Officer, and good to speak to you again this morning. So as the Chief Minister has said, since our update yesterday, we've recorded 19 new COVID-19 cases, with the total active cases associated with this outbreak 121. So just to remind you that, as mentioned, these higher numbers than yesterday are expected due to the change in our cut-off times, and this is the 24-hour period now. Of these new cases today, I can confirm, as the Chief has, that 17 of the 19 are linked to known cases and 2 are under investigation. Of the 19, 6 of these were infectious when in the community. And then overall, of all 121 total cases, the good news is that 117 of them either have links to known cases or links to exposure sites where we know transmission has occurred, and the 4 continue to remain under investigation. We now have 3 cases in our hospitals. 2 of these are COVID positive, but are not in hospital for COVID-related reasons, and we've talked about these ones before. We have an additional person in hospital receiving care for COVID-19 now. At this time, this person is stable and does not require any ventilation or breathing support. Since our last update, we have over... Just let me check the numbers for you. I think they've been translated incorrectly. Everyone moves very quickly in the morning, so... Actually, I will come back to you later about the numbers in quarantine. We actually have over 15,500 close contacts who are currently in quarantine, which, including our individuals in quarantine from COVID-19 affected areas, we have almost 18,000 people in quarantine. We also now have over 320 exposure locations spread across the ACT, so please continue to stay up to date with those exposure locations. So noting the media reporting this morning, I can confirm that there is a positive case of COVID-19 linked to the Australian National University, the ANU. Our teams have been working very closely with the ANU throughout the entire pandemic and are continuing to do so. At this stage, we have not confirmed any exposure sites on campus, but this continues to remain under investigations. I think it's important to acknowledge that this is a challenging time for everyone, and during our outbreaks in particular, but it can be even more challenging for the vulnerable members of our community. With respect to this, there's 2 things that I just wanted to touch on this morning. Since our last update, case investigations from one of our current active cases has identified that the Condamine Court in Turner, which is a housing ACT managed complex, is being explored as a potential exposure location. I would really like to stress that this is still very much an evolving situation, but one that we have prepared for. We have comprehensive plans in place for a range of high-risk and vulnerable settings, including high-density public housing, and we will implement these plans based on a thorough investigation of the situation, which is an ongoing investigation today. I would like to assure everyone that our approach here will be far more than a health response. Our focus will be very much on supporting the tenants and their needs as we work through this. We are working closely with a broad range of our partners, including Housing ACT and the Community Services Directorate, to communicate directly with those affected as we need to. Additionally, as the Chief Minister has identified, we are also currently managing a cluster of cases in the disability sector. At this stage, this is a total of 14, 12 of which are ACT residents, and Minister Stephen Smith will provide a little bit more information about what we're doing with the sector in this space. And to provide the broader update on the outbreak, which I've started to regularly do, we continue to have our 3 cases in the surrounding New South Wales region, which we count as part of our overall ACT outbreak, so no change there. 40% of our cases are in people aged 0 to 17 years, 47% 18 to 44 years, 13% aged 45 years and over. The number of public sites of transmission remains at 8 and are the same sites as yesterday. Before I finish, I always like to acknowledge a new part of the response, and today I'd like to talk about Access Canberra, ACT Health and the Vaccine Booking Call Systems, as well as our Public Information Coordination Centre, who've been working really hard to answer your questions and keep you informed. Since the lockdown commenced, we have been receiving an absolute massive amount of numbers of calls, comments, exemption requests and vaccination bookings. This tells me that the community is engaged and you are all continuing to be interested in what we are doing, which is fantastic. But I would like a special shout out to these teams who just continue to handle this amazing volume of interest with extraordinary professionalism and dedication.